Hi everyone. Today we are going to discuss the topic is how to invoke an Apex class from Lightning component and how we can pass the parameters from Lightning component to Apex controller and how we can get the result from the Apex controller to Lightning component. Okay. And here we are going to discuss three examples. One is whatever we did yesterday through Lightning calculator. We are going to do the same thing by invoking an Apex class by sending the first number and second number as parameters and getting the sum and additional result to the Lightning component. And then we are going to have an Apex class which can save the record into standard object or custom object. Then we are going to invoke the same thing from the Lightning component. And along with that, we are going to discuss how to display list of records by using ARA iteration tag. Let's see everything practically. So first thing is, whenever you want to create an Apex class, Apex methods, which will be invocable from Lightning component, you have to make that method ARA enabled. Okay, you have to use ARA enabled annotation. Let's see. So we have test component, right? I'm just giving the test component controller. You can give any name. Now you have to use ARA enabled annotation. Let's write public static void. Decimal is the return type. Get addition result. And it should be ARA enabled. And then decimal. Second number and you can return the result. That's it. I am not doing anything else other than addition of two numbers. Okay, if we observe here, we have a method get additional result and which can take two parameters. The parameters names are FST number and SEC number, that is first number, second number, and we are adding two and we are returning the same thing. So simple method. Now, how we are going to utilize this method? First of all, to use this, to invoke this ARA enabled method, you have to include this Apex controller in your component. How can you include? By using controller attribute. Go to your Apex, Lightning component, and this is your Lightning component. Here, you can put controller, and then you have to include your Apex class as a controller here. Then whenever you include an Apex class in the controller of a component, then it becomes as Lightning component controller. And this component is ready to invoke the methods from this controller if they are ARA enabled methods. Okay. Now, so when they click on sum, then it is going to call addition method in the JavaScript controller. From here, I'm going to comment this. Let's see whether it works or not for now. See, nothing will happen because I commented that code, which is going to set the result to the result attribute. Now, that result will be calculated through our Apex class. What we have to do? First thing is how to follow something. Var action, you can give any name, otherwise addition also you can give, equals component dot get of C is a default namespace. Then you have to specify the method name. What is the method name? Get additional result. And we have parameters also. Then addition dot set params, and you have to follow JSON format, open curly brace and close curly brace, key value params, key value parameters. That means your parameter is a key and your value as a value parameter, okay? And second parameter is a CC number, and for this you have to send second number colon done. So with this, what you are doing, you are just passing the parameters by using the set params method. Set params is the standard method to pass parameters to the controller method. Next, what else we can have? We have to write callback method. Set callback. Okay, that means to get the results from the method, you have to write set callback method. Here you will have two parameters. One is this. This represents the this component, and function of, there is one parameter, result or response, whatever you can put. Then now this response holds all the result from the Apex method. Okay, what it can give to get the result or returned from the Apex controller, what you have to do? Var equals, okay, response dot get return value. This is the method. Okay, so just to put alert for now. Done. Then to make it executed, you have to follow one more thing. After these things, you have to use dollar $j dot nq action. So it will make this method in the queue. If you have multiple methods in Lightning component, nq action, and you have to specify your third name, what you defined. Done. So invalid Aura API source. Method name, we have nq method. This is done. So nq action, so whenever you put your action in the nq action method, then it will Salesforce will make it in a queue. If you have multiple methods, it will execute in the queue, otherwise it will execute. Until you put this action in the enqueue action, even you write everything correct, but it can't execute. It is very important. Okay, you can execute with this only. Let's go to our app. Let's try to execute it, whether it can give a result or not. See, it gave result 33. Now I want to assign the same result to the attribute, result attribute. Go to this, just where you have to add this result here. Done. Okay, now let's see. Changing this 34, let's see how it looks like. Yes, so now what we did, we know how to send the parameters and how to invoke the controller method. First of all, whenever you want to make a method invocable from the Lightning component, you have to write a Apex class and the method which should be RI enabled. And the method should be always static. Static method. Okay. This is the how to make it as static method always. And then from Lightning component, okay, before you are invoking this method, you have to include your Apex class as a controller in Lightning component. And then you have to pass the parameters like this. So you just need to invoke the method and then you have to pass the parameters by using setParams method, and after that you have to use setCallback method by for getting the result from the Apex controller, then setting the result in the attribute wherever you want. That's it. This is how we can do Apex invocation from Lightning component. Now we are going to discuss about how to create a record. Okay, we already have a class. Let's see. And one more thing before I'm going to jump into saving the record, so let's discuss about the helper also. Sometimes according to best practices, you should not write everything in the controller. You have to write the methods in helper. That means you have to write logic in the helper method with helper, and then you have to invoke that method from the controller. See, I'm going to write a method. If you see here, helper addition, okay, and I'm passing these parameters. Okay, I need component or event. For now, I don't need event. What else we have? And I'm going to copy. Paste here, and then I am going to use this method helper dot. What's the method name? This is the method name. And these are the components. Done. So let's see the result. Now that means it looks fine and it is the best practice also. You should not write everything in the controller. You have to write the logic in everything in the helper methods, and then you have to invoke them from the controller. Let's see the result, how it looks like. No change in the result. Okay, see, 33 came. It is giving addition properly. Only the thing is, you moved code from controller to helper and you are invoking the same thing from controller. That's the best practice. And then now we are going to discuss how to create a record. Yes. So I'll show you the input, I mean output first of all, then I will give you explanation on this. I already written code. Okay. See, if you see here, so I have input first name, last name and phone number, and I have a table also. Okay. Whenever I add input here, for example, if I give here, then automatically it will save the record and it will add the record into the table at first position. Okay, this is what I am going to discuss with you. Okay, here I am going to split this into two parts and I'll explain one by one. See, so first thing is, this is the method, ARA enabled method with the create contact method. Here what I am sending, contact obj, that means I am going to send an entire instance, but for that instance we have different inputs on the Lightning component. It can take and it can insert and it can return the contact record ID. That's what we did in this method. And the second method is, I am just retrieving all the contacts, okay, up to 5 contacts, and I am returning that into the Lightning page, Lightning component. Let's see how it works. First thing is, I'll show you. Contact creation component. You don't need all these things as you are going to run this component through application. Okay. Now, first thing is what you have to do. See, controller. What is the controller name here? Create contact class 1. That's what you gave here. Done. Now, whenever you are going to give an instance of object to controller, okay, Apex controller, first of all you have to define attribute with the object type. See here, so if you see this, I defined an attribute with the name contact obj, and type is, what is the attribute type? It should be contact object type, and in the default attribute you have to give a JSON format with the values. What is the input you want to give? One is a subject type contact. Okay, that means you are representing, you are going to work on contact object, and what all the fields you want to show. Okay, what all the field you want to use, and what is the default values for that field? First name, last name, phone. By default, it is empty. Okay. Now, I want contact ID here. One more attribute to show the record ID. Done. Okay. Next. Now, whatever we did yesterday, I am doing the same thing. So, So what we have to learn here, these are all copy pasted from Lightning Design System. Okay, like yesterday we saw this example, article cards. Okay, and only the thing is, what we are doing, a Lightning input. In the Lightning input, value should be, it should take contact obj dot first name, v dot contact. Contact obj is our attribute name, dot name, that is the field name of contact. Like this, we gave last name phone also. And then I have method is okay. I have a button. What is the button name? Do save. Okay. Now we are going to see that also. See, I'm just copy pasting. I'll explain everything here. See, you don't need to follow only this my action only. You can have this. And if you see here, create contact is the controller method, which is RI enabled method. Okay. And then okay, so this is RA enabled method, and if you see here, we are setting the parameter. Okay, cont obj is the parameter name of apex method, and which parameter values we want to send, contact obj, this is the attribute in the Lightning component, where we are having first name, last name and phone, and we are sending using the set parameters, set params method, and we are adding the or we are setting the contact ID, which is returning from this method. Okay, and enqueue action done. Let's see how it will be. Now I am going to create an application to see this output. Contact creation, connect app, component app. So as you know, for applying styles, you should extend force colon SLDS, and then you have to include your component by using default namespace. And let's see. See here, and what is this? This is a toast message user interface. Okay, let me show you that also, where we return. This is the one. Okay, SLDS notify content. If you see this, notify toast and SLDS theme success. You can have these things in Lightning Design System. Just copied and pasted and replacing the values with our own values. Okay, like contact ID. I want contact ID when it is saved. Let's see. Test contact creation. Otherwise, why we want everything? Okay, let's see. See, if you see here you have contact ID. So if you want to see whether it is created or not, you can see Srivalli. See, Srivalli, we have created, and phone number. This is how we can save a record into the database. Now we are going to show you how to display records. Okay, in the same component. Okay, now for showing the list of contacts, you have to define attribute with the list type. Okay, what is the attribute we can define? Let's see. The attribute is contact list. Okay, let's go with this. So here in our component, I'm going to add contact list as an attribute. Okay, and what else we have to do? We have to use ARA iteration. So if you see here, I'm just so this is also Lightning styles only. Table class SLDS table, SLDS table cell buffer, all these things copied from Lightning design system. I added header in the T head, okay, with the different styles. Okay, title should be in capital letters like this. Okay, first name, last name, and whatever the records I retrieved from Apex controller, I have to set that result to the contact list attribute here. Okay, once in the contact once I set the contact list, then you can utilize that here. Okay, here v dot contacts in ARA iteration tag, you will have one attribute items where you have to place or you have to include your contact list. Okay, and you have to define where that means variable for that list. Okay, to access the values, to access the record values, and you can have index where as index. Okay, and then you can have contact obj, contact obj dot first name, contact obj last name. In page block table also, in Visual Force, okay, we have apex colon page block table value equals list of contacts. Okay, where equal contact obj, like that. Like that, in Lightning component also, you have to use ARA iteration for displaying the records, and you have to include your list of records in items attribute, and you have to define your variable by using var attribute. Okay, and what else we have to display list of records in Lightning component? We have Lightning data table also. Okay, you will see in the next sessions. For now, let's discuss ARA iteration only. Here I have completed ARA iteration with items and variable, and I'm just doing the rows here. For every record, there will be one row and with the column values, first name, last name. Okay, and I have defined everything in the Lightning component, but I have to load these values on load. Whenever component loads, I want to load these records into contact list. How we can do that? First of all, we should have a method. Okay, let's have a method to access the values. For now, we already have a method to access the contacts. Okay, that means to access 5 contacts from the database. So for that purpose, I am calling this show contacts method. I mean, I have defined show contacts method here in our component. And here, if you see here, I'm just retrieving the contacts. Okay, and this retrieve contacts method doesn't have any parameters. That's why you don't need to use the set parameters, because you don't need to send any parameter. After that, you just need to have a set callback method, and component dot set v dot contact list is the attribute you defined in the Lightning component, and you are getting the result from the method. Okay, this is how it will be. So let's see the output. Nothing happened, right? You have first name, last name, but no contacts displayed. And we have defined a method, show contacts method, but we didn't invoke any that method from anywhere, even through button, even through anything, we didn't invoke. Okay, but we want to invoke that method when component loads. Whenever component loads, then I want to invoke that methods automatically. Okay, how we can do that? We have init action. Okay, let's define. We have init handler. We have to use that to invoke a method automatically when component loads. So what we have to do, first thing is we have to use this, the standard handler. Whenever you want to invoke a method when component loads, then you have to use the handler init. It is the standard name. You have to give init only, and this value is this. And after that, in action attribute, you have to give your method name, which will be invoked in onload of or in load of your Lightning component. Here, what method I am invoking? Show contacts. In that show contacts, I have implementation which invokes retrieve contacts method, and it is returning the result. I am holding the result into the contact list attribute, and I am using this contact list in the iteration tag. So now let's see. So if you see, I put data instead of response here. That means whatever you can, but you should know the purpose of this function parameter. Okay, you can have any name. The purpose of this parameter is you can have the return values, and you can check the whether it is giving the error or not by using the getState method, whether it is complete, whether it is having the error, whether it is in the incomplete. Okay, you can have that things by using not only getReturnValue. GetReturnValue will give you the only return value which comes from the method. But if you want to see whether it is giving the error, whether it is completed, or whether it is in progress or incomplete, then you have to use getState method, data.getState. You can have that. Okay, and you can see that also. Put alert just to give you data dot get state what it will give you. Let's see success. It gives these values. So basically, when you are writing anything, when you are assigning something, you have to use this getState method. If it is success, then you have to assign that values. If it is not success, you have to show some errors. If it is incomplete, you have to show any loading messages. Like that, you have to handle. For now, what we are doing, we are assigning the values directly. See, it loads records automatically. Now, if I add something, it will add, but it is not adding any record into the table if you observe. Okay, let's see that also, how we can add the record when it saved into the database, and how we can add the same thing into the table what we are displaying the records. Let's see. Nothing, it's very simple. First thing is, whenever you click on save method, save button, it is invoking this do save method. Then whenever you click on do save method, there itself you are getting the input. Okay, that's why you have to write that logic which needs to be added to the data table, okay, which are having the data. Okay, first thing is you have to retrieve all the contacts which is displayed by using component dot get of vContact list. Okay, because on load it loads the 5 contacts. You have to get the 5 contacts, because what you have to, why you have to retrieve means you want to make your latest input as a first record into your table. And whatever you have, this set callback, everything is okay. After everything, see, as I told you, you have to put if. Okay, always you have to have this equals data dot get state. The best practice is if state equals, then only you have to process all these things. That is correct. Okay, for now I'm removing these things just to make you understand. You have to follow that while you are doing in real time. And now what I am going to do, once I have everything successful, then I want to add that record into the contact list where I got the contact list. Contact list dot splice is a method to push the records into the contact list or array. Okay, and here there is three parameters. One is where you want to add this record. What is the position? I want to add this record at the 0th index, that means first position, and I don't want to remove any records, any elements in the array. That's what is the second parameter thing. If you put one, then it will remove one record. Okay, and here you are adding one contact obj. That means you are adding your latest record, what you are giving the input. Done. And then after adding that, again you are loading, or you are giving, or you are setting the contact list, whatever you prepared with the latest value, to the contact list again. That's all. Done. Now let's see the output. Okay, done. Let's see. See, Bugs Bunny added at the 0th position, and no records removed from here. And this is the Bugs Bunny record created. It is giving the record ID also. Okay, this is how we can add records, and we can display the records, we can save the records. Now with this session, what we learned, we have learned how to invoke Apex method, and that method should be RI enabled annotated method. To invoke that method from the Lightning component, and before invoking that Lightning component method, you have to include that Apex class as a controller in Lightning component, and then you have to send the parameter. We have to invoke the method by using component dot get of c dot method name, and then by using set params, you can send the parameters in the JSON format by using your variable name and value. Okay, parameter name and value. And to get the values, to get the response, you have to use set callback method. And in the set callback method, you have two parameters. This represents this component and current component, function of the parameter, whatever the parameter handles the return value. In that parameter, you, whenever you want to see whether it is success or incomplete or completed, then you have to utilize get state method. I already explained that. And to execute these things, you should use, or you should put your action in the enqueue action method with the $a namespace. Okay, this is the thing what we learned today. And second thing is, here you have to remember, whatever the variables you are using in the JavaScript controller, you should not use the same name in the Apex controller method. Otherwise, even you write the proper code, it won't work. That's what you have to take care. And one more thing, we saw that we used splice method. That's a JavaScript method. It's not the Lightning method. Okay. And while you are working on Lightning component, you should have basic understanding of JavaScript also. It will be added advantage to you. Okay. All the best. Thank you. Let's meet in the next session.